Hello guys, welcome to the knowledge domain, the concept of life sciences and biotech. In this lecture series, we are focusing on the nervous system. Before, we have discussed the synapse, and there are some hierarchy of the various domes of the brain, and which part of the brain is involved in which type of functions. So, brain is very vital, so it is protected in the cranium, the brain box, which is the cranial vault. It is also called the encephalon. So it has three major portions, the cerebrum, that includes cerebral hemispheres and the diencephalon. The brain stem includes the midbrain and the pons and the medulla oblongata of the hindbrain, as well as the cerebellum. It is protected by the three layers of conjunctive tissue membrane covering called the meninges, and the shock protection is provided by the cerebrospinal fluid that bath the brain both inside and outside, and it support as well as it protect it from the trauma. Considering the post-embryonic division, brain can be divided into three sections or the three portions. Prosencephalon, that include telencephalon and diencephalon, mesencephalon and rhomboencephalon include pons, medulla is also called the myelencephalon and the cerebellum, based on the post-embryonic division. Then this telencephalon of the prosencephalon has the cerebral hemispheres, the white matter and the basal ganglia. This cerebral hemispheres is separated by several fissures in the pulp cerebri, interconnected with the fiber corpus callosum that we will see in one of the following slides. It has six lobes and olfactory structures. The six lobes of the cerebral hemispheres are frontal lobe, two parietal lobes, two temporal lobes, and one occipital lobe. There is an insular lobe and a limbic lobe, which is a C-shaped structure and encircle corpus callosum that join the two cerebral hemispheres. Coming to the visual of the brain that we have discussed earlier, so this is the cerebral cortex. This is a side view, so we can see one cerebral cortex. And here you will see the lateral ventricle. This is the internal space of the cerebral cortex that is filled with the cerebrospinal fluid. This is the choroid plexus. This is the highly vascularized, from where this cerebrospinal fluid is synthesized or it is generated from the obverse block that is highly vascularized, the choroid plexus. So it is generated from the blood and it is synthesized here in the choroid plexus. The two lateral ventricle is connected to the third ventricle that is present in the midbrain of the mesencephalon by the foramen of the Monroe. Then this third ventricle connected with the fourth ventricle that is found in the medulla oblongata by the aqueduct of the Sylvius. And this is medulla oblongata. This is ependymion. This is also a vascular layer. And it is also involved in the some contribution in the secretion of the cerebrospinal fluid. Then these are the three protective layer of the brain, the meninges, the dura mater is the outermost covering, the arachnoid, which is just below the dura mater, the pia mater, it is highly vascularized. Okay, this is the pons. And the fornix is also slightly vascularized. And the corpus callosum, this is the white matter that connects the two parietal, the two cerebral hemispheres. Okay. And these are the arachnoid villus. And this is serrated sinus that is filled with the cerebrospinal fluid. And inside and the outside, the cerebrospinal fluid protects the brain. So in this area, you can see that this is the thalamus, means that is a part of the diencephalon, and below the thalamus, this area is the hypothalamus, and Here, this is the amygdala, and this is the, this area is the hippocampus. So the diencephalon is the epithalamus, thalamus, hypothalamus, then subthalamus. So these all are present here. And this small structure, you see, this is the pituitary. This is the hypothalamus, and this is the pituitary. Coming to the spinal cord, that is lodged in the vertebral column, and there are seven cervical vertebrae. From the seven cervical vertebrae, there are eight cervical spinal nerves. Okay, so it starts before the beginning of the first cervical vertebrae and the end of the seven cervical vertebrae. There are the 12 thoracic spinal nerves, 5 lumbar spinal nerve, 5 sacral spinal nerve, and 1 popliteal spinal nerve. So there are total 31 spinal nerves. So 8 from the cervical area, from the out, it is coming out from the 7 cervical vertebrae. So the brain part, the first one is the olfactory structure, that is the part of the telencephalon. So it has the olfactory bulb and the tract, and it receives the sensory nerve, the olfactory nerve, that is the cranial nerve 1. So all the 12 cranial nerves we will discuss on the following slide. And the other structure, that those are the basal ganglia. This, they are the small islands of the neuron cell body present on the fibers of the ventral surface of the cerebral cortex. So these are the subcortical nuclei or the telencephalon. Nuclei means it is a cluster of the cell body of the neuron. So that is the gray matter. These are the basal ganglia. The examples are the caudate nucleus, putamen, globus pallidus, amygdala, that we have seen earlier, nuclear complex. So olfactory structure, basal ganglia, these all are found in the telencephalon. That, as we have seen in the previous slide, the two lateral ventricles are connected to the third ventricle, that is found in the midbrain of the megacephalon by the foramen of Monroe. And the white matter, that is found in the surface of the cerebral cortex, and the corpus callosum that connect the two cerebral lines. The other white matter area, distinct parts are the rostrum, genu, body, and the splenium. Then the diencephalon, it is having the all the thalamus, epithalamus, thalamus, hypothalamus, subthalamus, we have seen in the previous image. And it receives the optic nerve, which is also sensory. This is the cranial nerve 2. So the cranial nerve 1 is means the sensory, and that is the olfactory, and it is receiving by the olfactory structures. And the cranial nerve 2, that is the optic nerve, it is received by the diencephalon. Then the cerebral aqueduct, or the aqueduct of the sylvius, it connects the third and the fourth ventricle, so that the cerebrospinal fluid that is secreted or generated in the choroid plexus is moving within the various ventricles, and how it is reaching the blood vascular system, that also will be discussed in detail in one of the following slides. So next is the megacephalon. So it generates the oculomotor nerve, that is the cranial nerve 3, and the trochlear nerve, which is the cranial nerve 4, and it is the only cranial nerve that exceeds dorsal aspects. So, the auditory and the visual reflexes, it is responsible for megacephalon. And there is the substantia nigra, it is the largest nucleus found in the megacephalon. So megacephalon is the largest nucleus, that is substantia nigra. These are all also the nucleus, that is the caudate nucleus, putamen, these are also nucleus. So if you compare the cluster of the cell body that is suspended or that is floating, it is not floating, it is found in the sea of the fibers, are called the nucleus. And among them, the largest one is the substantia nigra, found in the megacephalon of the midbrain. Then the pons is the part of the hindbrain. There are four cranial nerves that is coming out from here. The fifth one is the trigeminal, then abducens. Facial is the seventh one. Vestibulo cochlear, this is from the inner ear, it is the eighth one. Then the other four from the medulla oblongata. The 9th is glossopharyngeal, 10 is the valgus, 11th is the accessories. So this accessory is actually slightly disputed that it is cranial or non-cranial based on the function, it is put in the cranial nerves and actuated the hypoglossal nerves. So the cerebrospinal fluid, before going to the cerebrospinal fluid, the tentorium cerebelli, you can see this is the tentorium cerebelli, and these are the two temporal lobes and the one occipital lobe of the cerebral cortex. How it is separated from the cerebellum? It is through the tentorium cerebelli. Okay, and it found the roof of the fourth ventricle, that is found in the medulla oblonga. And the pyrometer, that is close to the cerebrospinal, that is close to the brain, and it is highly vascularized. We have seen, we have discussed earlier. And the two other layer that is protecting the brain are the arachnoid and the dura mater. Those are actually non-vascular. Okay. And dura mater is outermost covering, so it is the dense connective layer. So next, coming to the cerebrospinal fluid, that is formed or generated or secreted from the choroid plexus, which is highly vascular. There is 500 ml per day secretion of the cerebrospinal fluid, but at a time we can see 140 ml of cerebrospinal fluid found in the entire brain. So cerebrospinal fluid circulation, it is synthesized choroid plexus in the lateral ventricle, then to the third ventricle, then to the fourth ventricle. From the fourth ventricle, it goes to the subarachnoid space. So this is the subarachnoid space. Okay, from the subarachnoid space, it will go to the superior sagittal sinus that we have seen, that is covering the outermost layer of the brain. And from superior sagittal sinus, it is reaching to the venous blood. So the cerebrospinal fluid that is synthesized or formed or secreted from the blood in the choroid plexus and to some extent in the ependema, that is finally reaching to the blood. So the circulation is completed. The composition of the cerebrospinal fluid. So the pH is 7.5 because it is present in the tissue. So it is receiving the excreted CO2 from the cells of the brain, so the pH is lower because there is more CO2, means there is more aqueous concentration, so the pH is less because the CO2 partial pressure in the artery is the 40 slim, means millimeter of mercury, and in the tissue it is 45 millimeter of mercury, means there is more CO2. More CO2 means more aqueous means less pH. Usually the pH of the blood is 7.4, but in case of the brain, it is 7.35 because it is a fluid of the tissue. Specific gravity of the cerebrospinal fluid is slightly denser than the water, 1.07. There is 65 milligram per deciliter of the glucose, and the protein is 15 to 50 milligram per deciliter. Pressure is 80 to 180. That is providing protection to the brain components, cerebrospinal fluid. So, having a slightly better view, we know the sequence. So here the choroid plexus is present, from here the cerebrospinal fluid is secreted. These are the two lateral ventricles. This is the lateral aspect. So from here it is moving to the third ventricle. From the third ventricle it is moving to the fourth ventricle. And finally subarachnoid space, then the superior sagittal sinus, and finally for the blood. And in the dorsal view, it is from the dorsal side, so it is synthesized here. These are the lateral ventricle, this is the third ventricle, this is the fourth ventricle, and from the fourth ventricle, it is reaching the subarachnoid space, then superior sagittal sinus, and finally to the venous blood. There are 12 cranial nerves we have discussed, both in case of the AVs, the birds and the mammals. The first one is the olfactory, mediate the sense of the smell, olfaction, that is received in the olfactory structures of the forebrain or the cerebral cortex. Then the optic nerve, this is the cranial nerve too, it subserves the vision and the pupillary light reflexes. So from the midbrain or the mesencephalon, there are the two cranial nerves, they are coming out. One is the oculomotor, the cranial nerve, purely motor nerve that moves the eye, constricts the pupil and accommodates. Trochlear, the only cranial nerve, that is the dorsal exit. It innervates the superior oblique, which depresses, intors and abducts the eye, also motor function. Trigeminal cranial nerve 5, this is from the pons, 5, 6, 7, 8 are from the pons. Muscle mastication, mediate general sensation from the face, eye, and the nasal and the oral cavities. Abduction cranial nerve 6, also from the pons, innervates the lateral vectors, which abducts the eye. Facial nerve mediates the facial movement along with the taste, salivation, and lacrimation. And the 8, vestibulocochlear nerve, the inner ear, maintains balance and mediates hearing. These are from the medulla oblongata, glossopharyngeal, cranial nerve 9. Taste, salivation, along with the cranial nerve 9, the cranial nerve 10, the vagus and the 12, hypoglossal, it is involved in the swallowing. Vagal nerve, the number 10, along with the cranial nerve 9, that is the glossopharyngeal, and the 12, that is the hypoglossal, involved in the swallowing. Along with it, it mediates phonation, palate elevation, the taste. 11, the accessory nerve, this is the cranial nerve 11. Not actually cranial nerve, as it originates in the spinal cord, that we have discussed earlier. Mediate head and the shoulder movement. And the cranial nerve 12, that is the hypoglossal, along with the 9 and the 10, it is involved in the swallowing as well as the tongue movement. So here we can see that this is the sensory, the optic nerve 2. But the movement of eye involved cranial nerve 3, cranial nerve 4, cranial nerve 6 and 5 for the movement of the eye. By the swallowing involves 9, 10 and the 12. So these are the various places. The first two cranial nerves, one is from the olfactory, and the second one is the optic one. So the third and the fourth are from the midbrain. Okay, first two are from the forebrain, those two are the sensory. Four are from the pons, from the 5 to 8, and 9 to 12 are from the medulla oblongata. So the number 4, that is the trochlear, you get the dorsal exit in the midbrain. Autonomic nervous system is a general visceral efferent motor system that controls and regulates smooth muscles, cardiac muscles, and the gland. Two types of projections neurons are found in this, the preganglionic and the postganglionic neurons. Okay, it is from the very essential function of the body performed by the autonomic nervous system. The first one is the sympathetic, which is thoracolumbar, means the nerves originated are the spinal nerves from the thorax, that dual spinal nerves, and the lumbar, the 5 spinal nerves, so there are 17. And the neurotransmitter and the receptor used are the adrenergic system, because it is the beta 2 adrenergic receptor, and it is the norepinephrine, the neurotransmitter. It is mobilized during the more energy requiring, and the situation is like the fight, flight, and the flight response. Include heart rate, force of contraction, and increased blood pressure, because when a person is frightened, so heart starts pumping more blood, so the heartbeat increases. It is a myelinated action that leads the spinal cord to the ventral root. And the sympathetic ganglia situated slightly distance, at a distance from the spinal cord. And the postganglionic fiber that travels a long distance to reach the target organ. So So the distance between the ganglion and the full ganglion fiber or originated and the organ, it is very high. The distance is high. And on chromaffin cells in the adrenal medulla, sympathetic post ganglionic axons are on myelinated. So pre ganglionics are myelinated, post ganglionic are on myelinated. Coming to the parasympathetic, it is craniosacral, means there is the vagus is involved in the parasympathetic, which is the cranial nerves, as well as the glossopharyngeal is also the cranial nerve that is also involved in the parasympathetic function, and the cholinergic system, the sacral, there are the five sacral nerves, and the cholinergic, because the neurotransmitter is acetylcholine, and it stimulates activities that conserve energy and restores body resources. So when the energy is conserved, means heart rate will be less, and energy is conserved, means digestion will increase, absorption will increase, so reduce heart rate, increase digestion and absorption. And the ganglia situated within or close to the target organs, unlike the sympathetic, where the target organs is far from the ganglion, there it is close to the target organ. These are the two major autonomic nervous system. The third one we already discussed in the GA physiology, the enteric nervous system, that is formed on the two sides of the circular muscle. One is between the circular muscle, the other in the submucosa, that is called the submucosal plexus, the mucinal plexus. And this myenteric plexus between the longitudinal and the circular muscles, it is called the myenteric plexus or the Purkinje plexus. It is responsible for the GA movement. And there is a fourth one, it is a mix of the nerve fiber that is from the spinal cord, hypothalamus and the brain stem. So it is not so well for the autonomic nervous system, but this is also involved in the essential functions of the body. So the two major, sympathetic, parasympathetic, the third one is the enteric, and then the fourth one, it is involving the nerve from the spinal cord, hypothalamus, and the brain state.